Hello and welcome. Today we have with us one of the firebrand politicians of the turmoil hit Jammu and Kashmir state, the former independent MLA from Langet constituency in Handwara, Mr. Engineer Rasheed. Engineer Rasheed, welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Let me first begin by asking you, what are your prospects of winning North Kashmir's Baramulla parliamentary seat?
For me, that is immaterial. I don't believe in living in a world of imaginations. People have voted, whatsoever will be their decision, I will have to abide by it, and I try to give my best, I try to reach out to people, so I don't care about the result, neither I do predict things.
But there was also a killing in your constituency at the end of the day.
That was a sponsored killing. I have been crying from day one. In 2014 also, there took a killing place in my constituency. And in 2019, when the parliamentary election was there, that area had to go in for mass voting for Engineer Sheikh. It was managed by very few state actors, a section of them, which is acting as a collaborator with, unfortunately, with my political opponents, and they ensured a killing which was most unfortunate, and it was just to prevent Engineer Sheikh from getting 7,000 to 10,000 more additional votes.
And whom do you blame
for? I have already said that. I have told you that a section of officers from the security establishment, in consultation with my political opponents. You know whom I am referring to.
On April 12th, 2019, you wrote in your article, and I quote, that you alleged that Sajjad Loans party ensured boycott in your constituency in many pockets of North Kashmir by hiring a section of professional stone.
Yes, now when you have quoted me from Greater Kashmir, that is truth. I firmly believe in it. His workers, unfortunately, they got indulged in the stool pelting. Purely, it was engineered, planned and executed in consultation with people within establishment, and at a proper time, I will name and shame them.
You have also alleged that deep state is working for Sajjad Loan. How truth is this?
When I say that boycott was ensured in my area, it obviously authenticates my claim, and let you talk to people of Palhal, let you talk to people of Baramulla and Sopur. Isn't it unfortunate that in those areas, you need not even an evidence, because especially in Palhalan and Patan areas, unfortunately, Imran Raza Ansari Saab, he ensured that boycott should take place here.
Why would he ensure
that? Because he wants to divide. Because he wants to divide people on sectarian lines, which is most shameful and dirty act. He tried to divide people in the name of Shia and Sunni, and he ensured that Shia should vote and Sunni should not vote. But this time, I am sure that tactics has also failed. The way Sajjad Saab tried to divide people in the name of parties and non-parties, but I am sure that people of Udi have rejected that theory, and similarly, people of Patan have also rejected that.
Engineer Saab, you are accusing a Shia leader, a prominent Shia leader, of dividing Kashmir on religious lines, on sectarian lines.
Sir, I have respect for him, but tell me for God's sake, isn't it a fact that let you study past few elections and you will definitely find that he has been playing the same dirty trick there? And this time, let me tell you one thing about Palhalan. I myself asked Deputy Commissioner Baramulla, who was the election in charge, I said to him that please, for God's sake, in Tantrepura and other areas, don't shift the polling stations to the place where you want them to, because there is not conducive atmosphere. Keep them at their native places. They assured me that we will not do that, but in the last night of the campaigning, hidden hands worked and all the polling stations were shifted to a locality where people couldn't vote.
Have Sunnis voted this time?
Not to that extent. I don't believe in. I am neither a Shia nor a Sunni.
But you are accusing a prominent Shia leader.
He doesn't represent Shias. He is just exploiting their sentiment. Claiming himself to be Maulana Imran Raza Ansari and wearing a skin tight, he can't be a religious scholar. I'm sorry to say.
And you had an understanding with Shah Faisal. How did that?
No, I had not no understanding with him. But all that, what happened, you know it. When he resigned from the job, I requested him that let us work together. He had his own compulsions. Then I asked him, if you want to contest, I will support you. He had again some his own motives, but when I decided to contest, it was just 3 days before the campaigning ended. Shah Faisal announced through a Facebook post his support to me, for which I am thankful to him.
There was no understanding.
We never met. We never discussed that.
But
whether
there
we
is
should
a photograph on the social media that's circulating these days.
That is
between you and Shafiq.
Yes, yes, I will tell you. That photograph is of the day when polling took place. He had casted his vote, and we met. It was purely a coincidence.
That was April 11th.
That was April 11th. It was a purely coincidence when we met.
And no.
No, no, not at all. You can ask him also. We never met to discuss this thing. I simply made an appeal to him in a public meeting at Sogam when I visited there, that I request my dear brother Shah Faisal to support me. And after that, it took him 2 or 3 days and he supported. I though requested him that now when you have offered me his support, let you come and let us have a joint campaign. He might, I don't know what compulsions he had, but still I am thankful to him.
Mr. Engineer Rasheed, in this election campaign, many of your close aides were not with you. One of your founding members, Zeeshan Pandit, was also missing from the election campaign.
No, first let me be very honest and very clear cut that AIP is not a big party. We are really having small cadres. He is mostly engaged with his other activities at his at home, and he's not doing full time politics. So, but he conversed whatsoever he could do.
So this is not true that Awami Ittehad party is disintegrating. Or people come.
I think my late night campaigns should have opened eyes of New Delhi also, because I campaigned in the areas where you couldn't dream. I was the first, let me say now, the politician, it has become a dirty word here, first man who had a speech in Baramulla Chowk after 1989. I am the only
one. National Conference did a rally over there.
No, I am talking about Baramulla Chowk. They did it with that contention of wire and everything else, but in the dog bungalow, at a secure place. I stood up in the Baramulla man choke, which is a history in itself, given the circumstances we are facing since 1989.
Are we looking for an alliance in the upcoming assembly?
It is too early to say. It is too early to say. I have already said to you that I am ready to talk to Uday Thackeray and Syed Salahuddin, to anyone who will definitely talk about aspirations, sentiments and sacrifices of people of Jammu and Kashmir. Maybe I may talk to Shah Faisal Sahib and others also. My doors are always open. I am a small person. I try to make an understanding between NC and PDP also. If you check the records, you will find that I filed my nomination papers within last minute.
There were backdoor channels between you, PDP and National Conference.
Yes, absolutely. And with Sajjad Sahib also. I met Sajjad Sahib, I met Mahuba, I was in touch with Umar Abdullah also. I'm telling you, excuse me, all what I wanted them to do, that please let all the three regional forces unite. I mean PC, NC and PDP, let you unite, let you apologize to our people for the follies, for the dirty politics they have done. A simple apology will also work, and make a commitment. Assure people that we will not repeat the beaten tracks. We will follow a line which will be pro-people, and we will go for achievable things. But unfortunately, all the three were asking me that no, we can't work together. They sought my individual support, which I was never ready to give.
You asked for a public apology from Umar Abdullah, Mehbooba Mufti and Sajjad Lon.
Yes.
What you are saying?
At least there is some morality also, because they are responsible for all the miseries. I asked them that tell your masses, tell your people, tell people of Jammu and Kashmir that okay, we have failed in the past, we have done some mistakes, we will not do it. It was not a big deal.
How did all the three respond to
it? It was interesting. Umar Saab said that, not directly Umar Saab, his middlemen, whosoever they were, they asked that Umar Saab is saying that how can I join hands with Mahbooba Mufti? She has got BJP here, and my answer would be that you have done it already. And when I ask to PDP people, they would say that NC is mother of all evils. And when I ask it Sajjad Saab, he said that they are both traitors. So unfortunately, there's a Kashmiri saying, Shal Gupta Haksar. It was absolutely like that. And they destroyed the ego and self-respect of people of Jammu and Kashmir just to build their political capitals.
Engineer Saab, you also use unparliamentary language sometimes. Like you call the former chief minister of the state, Mehbooba Mufti,
Nagpur ki Nagin. Yes. I don't think it is unparliamentary
And you had never been so crude with Umar Abdullah.
Sir, you are wrong. Now, I can't check the records. Had you asked me first, I would have given you tens of examples.
There is no separate term for Umar Abdullah like you have done it.
Sir, please excuse me. I respect Mahbaji, I respect Umar Abdullah, I respect everyone. I have huge respect and regard. But the
how does this augur well
sir, excuse
Nagpur
me.
Ki Nagin?
Sir, excuse me, please, for God's sake. The politics in India should not be compared with politics in Jammu and Kashmir, because here we lose precious lives every day. Here it is violence on the streets. Here you are not allowed to travel on your so-called national highway. So sometimes what I have said, listen to me, how I am wrong. What do you mean by Nagpur ki Nagin? Because when she claims to be that she is Mujahida, and she claims that PDP workers are Mujahidas, I told in the assembly also that we expected you to be a Mujahida like Rizya Sultana. But you didn't prove Rizya Sultana, you proved Nagpur ki Nagin. Because every direction, every major which she took, it came from Nagpur. So obviously she was Nagpur ki Nagin, because if jab Nagin dasti hai, to kya hota hai, you know it. So obviously all the killings, they are on her head, all the blood that has flown in Jammu and Kashmir during her regime. So obviously she acted like a Nagin. So Nagpur ki Nagin, I told in that context, you need to see it in the right context.
Let's move to national stage a bit. You have been a vocal opposition to the Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Why is it so?
I am opponent to none. I just try to take side of the truth. I have also spoken the same thing when there was Manmohan Singh or someone else. Or tomorrow,
But consistently, you are welcoming Prime Minister to the state with black flag.
That is true. For the reason, I met Prime Minister last year on 18th of July. It was a one-hour meeting with him, one-to-one.
In New Delhi?
Yes, in New Delhi. I had not disclosed it for various reasons, but during my campaign, I told people that, yes, I met Prime Minister.
This is July 2018.
Yes, July 2018. I have given the date also. I categorically told him, sir, I want to help you. He said, how? I want to tell him, and I told it in public meetings also. That's why you see it, you call it, I am opposing him. I requested him that, for God's sake, leave suffering sub Kashmiris. Don't care about my sentiments. But tell me one thing, your parliament has passed a resolution claiming that entire J&K, including Gilgit Baltistan and Azad Kashmir, is entire part of India. Even a panchayat has a credibility. But for God's sake, parliament is something big. And if it is Indian parliament, it is the largest democracy of the world. And if the credibility of that parliament is eroded, we have got some 20 odd seats in J&K assembly reserved for citizens of PAK-occupied Kashmir, you may call it, or Azad Kashmir, you may call it. But you don't fill them up, and you similarly have a resolution claiming entire J&K to be India's part, but you are able to do nothing. I am giving you the roadmap. Either Pakistan should give you like a gift that part of Kashmir, your resolution will be implemented, or you should go for a war and get it. That is not the situation. So the only way is to implement your resolutions. Maybe entire people of Jammu and Kashmir, including Gilgit Baltistan, may vote for India, because Prime Minister in his 15th August speech 2015 had also made it clear. He claimed, Narendra Modi ji, that people of Gilgit Baltistan and POK want to be part of India. So then what is the problem? Because they claim that Jammu is entirely with New Delhi, Gilgit, Ladakh has no issues, and in Kashmir, what Sajjadun and Mahbub Mufti claimed, that 5% people want Azadi. So what was the reason to be getting afraid with withholding a plebiscite?
How did the Prime Minister respond?
It is not necessary for me to respond to everything. A proper time will come when I will tell my people. I think had he not responded, then he would not have called me. And it was, I am that he is, above all, he is Prime Minister of India, and I have respect for him that way. It was called from that side, and I as a small person, and I as a victim of violence, I as a sufferer, I had no objection to meet him.
Engineer Rasheed, thanks very much for talking.
Thank you, sir.